Okay, so connecting with the previous lecture, in that lecture I already discussed this, that how you will verify these three properties of the continuous probability distribution, that the probability of a specific event will be greater than or equal to 0. So we have already verified in the last lecture, if we put minus 1, because this is the interval which starts from minus 1 to 2, if we put any value of this interval in this equation, it will be greater than or it will be equal to 0. So when we put 0, it's equal to 0. When we put minus 1, it's greater than 0. When we put 2, definitely it will be greater than equal to 0. So this property is verified. In the next one, I have already discussed that how we will put this equation in this interval and how we will integrate it. So in this lecture, I am also going to show you that how you will calculate it. So you can see that minus infinity to plus infinity f of fx d of x. So why we start from minus infinity? Because as I already mentioned, that the function is defined, this function is defined only for 1 over x, 1 over 3 x square, which only defined for this interval. So in this interval start from minus 1. So this one is plus infinity, it starts from plus infinity, minus infinity, sorry. And this one is plus infinity. So this function will be equal to, this f of x is equal to 1 over 3 x square will be equal to 0 other than this interval. So if we calculate from minus infinity to minus 1, it will be equal to 0. So you can see minus infinity to minus 1, because this is the general formulation, that it will start from minus infinity to plus infinity, it will be equal to 0. So we just put 0. Then from minus 1 to 2, we want to calculate this area. So minus 1 to 2, 1 over 3, yes, this function is defined for this. So in f of x, we just write this 1 over 3 x square d of x value plus from 2 to plus infinity, this is plus infinity, this function is equal to 0, because it's already defined that elsewhere, that otherwise it will be equal to 0. So now you people know that how you will integrate it. So this will be equal to 0, 0 integration is equal to 0. So we not need to think about this, but we will only calculate this. So you people know that how you will use the integration formula. So just for the reminding, that to remind you that how you will calculate a specific area from A to B of f of x, d of x. So integration of this is x square, because this is 1, so it will be 1 plus 1, which is x square, divided by this 1 plus 1 and a to b, okay, plus c, we don't need to write that. So it will be equal to x square over 2 from a to b. So when we integrate it, 1 over 3 x square, 1 over 3 will become out, 1 over 3 will become out, this will be minus 1 to 2 x square d of x. So you need to apply the concept of integration formulation on this. It will be x 2 plus 1 and the interval starts from minus 1 to 2. So it will be 1 over 3 into, this will also be 1 over 3, 2 plus 1 is 3, and this will be x cube 2 minus 1 to 2. So when you simplify it, it will be 1 over 9 and x cube, which starts from minus 1 to 2. So when you simplify it, okay, when you simplify it, 2, you need to put 2 first, because the formula is b minus a. So 2 cube minus a is minus 1 power 3. So it will be 1 over 9. 8 minus 1 power 3 will be minus 1. So minus 1 into minus 1 will become plus 1. So 1 over 9 into 9 will become 1. So you can see when we simplify it, it will be equal to 1. And we, in this question, we only calculate, because this is the general formula, minus infinity to plus infinity, but the rest of the function is equal to 0. Because they already mentioned in the question. But we need to only calculate this area. So this area is equal to 1. And we already proved this. Okay, the second question is, calculate only this area. Because I am only interested, I am not interested in this whole area. I am only interested from 0. 0 to 1. So mathematically, x is greater than 0 and x is equal to 1 or x less than equal to 1. So it's mean we only need to calculate this area. So it is very easy, 0 to 1, and we know that this function from 0 to 1, this function is still fulfilling. It's not violating the rules. So we just write 1 over 3 x square. Then we simplify it. Now our lower bound is 0 and our upper bound is 1. 1 over 9 will become out. How it will be 1 over 9? Because I already show you x power 2 plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1. So 1 over 3, this become 1 over 9 and it will become x cube. So this is x cube. And now you need to, instead of minus 1 to 2, you need to put 0 is the lower bound and 1 will be the upper bound. So when you put an x cube, so in this one, 1 over 9, x cube, 0, 1. So 1 over 9, 1 cube minus 0 cube. So it will be 1 over 9 into 1. So this area will be equal to 1 over 9. So this area is equal to 1 over 9. 1 over 9 means this area is the 1 over 9 of this whole area. Which area? From 0 to 1. So at this way, you will calculate a specific area while using the concept of integration in continuous probability distribution. Okay, cumulative distribution function. If you remember, we have already studied that how you will calculate the cumulative distribution function in discrete probability distribution. But in this one, in the continuous, it is a little bit different. In discrete, if you remember that in a die example, if we throw a die, so x will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And their respective probabilities will be 1 over 6, 1 over 6, 1 over 6, 1 over 6, 1 over 6 and 1 over 6. So you also remember that cumulative distribution function in the discrete was, this will be 1 over 6, 1 over 6 plus 1 over 6, 2 over 6. This will be 3 over 6, 4 over 6, 5 over 6 and 6 over 6. The end one will be equal to 1. But in continuous, the formula is different. This is not a discrete because we already used this concept because the random variable was discrete. 1, 2, 3, when you throw a die, you will get 1, 2, you will get whole number. There will be no interval involved. But in this continuous, there is a specific interval involved. So the cumulative distribution function, which we will denote with f of x of a continuous random variable x with probability density function of f of x, is given by probability of x is less than or equal to x. So you remember in the cumulative distribution function, I mentioned to you that what will be the probability of x is less than or equal to 3. So if you have already calculated the distribution function, it will be equal to 3 by 6. It means probability of x is equal to 1, probability of x is equal to 2, plus probability of x is equal to 3. So 1 over 6 plus 1 over 6 plus 1 over 6, which will be equal to 3 by 6. But now the situation is different in the continuous probability distribution. Yes, we will write it same, x is less than or equal to x, just like we write it x is less than or equal to 3. But the formula, you need to remember this formula, it will be start from minus infinity to the x value. So for example, if they are asking us that calculate the area, if this is an area, okay, and they are asking us that what will be the cumulative distribution function, what will be the area from this point to this, okay. So we will write this up to B, what will be the cumulative, because cumulative it count all the previous one. So it will be start from minus infinity. If I ask you that x will be less than or equal to b, so how we will calculate this? Minus infinity to b and f of x. So this is f of t and d of t. So at this way you will calculate the cumulative distribution function. I will also show you that how you will calculate the cumulative distribution function in a normal distribution function. You also need to remember this, that x is greater than a and x is less than b. So how you will calculate x is less than or equal to b? For example, if I draw it, if this is a, this is b, we want to calculate this. So what will be x? X will be less than or equal to b. This whole area is included in x is less than b. Minus probability of x is less than or equal to a. So, x is less than or equal to a will be, this is a and this is b. So, x is less than or equal to a area will be this one. So, when you deduct this x is greater than or equal, less than or equal to a from x is less than or equal to b, you will get the cumulative distribution area of this one. And we will mathematically write it like this. In last example, so in the last example in which we calculate, in which we calculate specific area from minus 1 to 2, we already show that the probability will be greater than or equal to 0, and we also calculate the value for the area from 0 to 1 in the previous example. So now, in the previous example, you remember that from 0 to 1, they are asking us from this, only this area, how you will calculate this area. So while using the cumulative distribution function, I am going to show you, this is the same example. Now, we want to calculate the cumulative distribution function. So for x is less than or equal to minus 1, it means this area. This area. And we know that this function is defined, this function is equal to 0 if it is below from minus 1. So the general formulation of the cumulative distribution function probability for continuous probability distribution is f of x is equal to minus infinity to x f of t, this is f of t dt. So, because they are asking x is less than or equal to minus 1, so we know that this function is equal to 0. If it is outside from this interval, this is equal to 0. So, that is why it will be equal to 0. Now, we will calculate from minus 1 to 2. So, you remember that we have already calculated, so minus infinity, this area will be equal to 0. And then from minus 1 to x, let's suppose they are asking for this is x. So, 1 over 3 t square, because when we put this in the formula, this is t and this differentiate with respect to t. So, it will become 1 over 3 t square dt, then minus 1 to x, minus 1 to x. So, 1 over 3 t square. So, how we will calculate for this? 1 over 3 t square, 1 over 9, 1 over 3 will become outside and this will become t cube, 3, x and minus 1. So, it will become 1 over 9 t cube, x minus 1. So, then in the next step you need to put x, because this is x, you need to put x cube minus minus 1, this is lower bound, it will become 1 over 9 x cube plus 1. So, this is your cumulative distribution function for this question, for this question. Now, in the next step, for x is greater than equal to 2, for x is greater than equal to 2, so we know the function for this x is greater than or equal to 2. So, minus infinity to minus 1, we already know this is equal to 0. From minus 1 to 2, 1 over 3 t square. From 2 to x, this is equal to 0. So, once again, 1 over 3 t square. When you put this, it will give you the whole area which we already calculated in the previous example. This will be equal to 1. So, for this question, when x is less than or equal to minus 1. So, when x is less than or equal to minus, we have already calculated the cumulative distribution function. The function is 0, so it will be equal to 0. So, the cumulative distribution function when x is less than or equal to minus 1 will be equal to 0. What will be the cumulative distribution function when x is lie between minus 1 and 2? So, we have already calculated this. When the function x lie between minus 1 and 2, so we put this in the formula of cumulative distribution function, which is minus infinity to x f of t d of t, which gives us 1 over 9 x cube plus 1. So, this is my cumulative distribution function. And we have already calculated that what will be if it is greater than 2. If it is greater than 2, so once again the function is equal to, this will be equal to 0. If it is equal to 2, if it is start from minus infinity and if x is equal to 2. So, if it is start from minus infinity and it finish at 2, we know this start from minus 1. So, this whole area we have already calculated, it is equal to 1. This is equal to 1 and we have already calculated this is equal to 1. So, If it, x is greater than or equal to 2, it will be equal to 1. If x lies between 2 and minus 1, it will be this. And if it x less than equal to minus 1. So now the question is, how you will calculate using the cumulative distribution function? So the easiest way, you need to calculate this 0 to 1, 1 over 3, x square d of x. So 1 over 3, x cube by 3. Sorry, this is 1 and this is 0. So, it will be 1 over 9, 1 cube minus 0. It will be 1 over 9. So, sometime it will be very difficult to integrate a specific function. So, therefore, if you calculate cumulative distribution function, so you now need to just put the value. Okay, I am just putting the value now in this. If they are asking that calculate the area between 0 and 1, just calculate this area. So how we will calculate this area from 0 to 1? So you need to put f1 minus f0. So f1 1 over 9 x cube plus 1. So it will be 1 over 9 if x is equal to 1. So 1 plus 1, it will be 2 by 9. Okay, the next, if it, f is 0, so when f is 0, 1 over 9, 0 plus 1, it will be 1 over 9. So we just put 2 by 9 minus 1 over 9, which is equal to 1 over 9. And we have already calculated this while using the simple integration. So in the previous question, you remember, in the previous question, we have calculated the area between 0 and 1, which is 1 over 9. But if you calculate the cumulative distribution function, which is the formulation is FB, this is upper bound and this is lower bound. But before going to that, you need to calculate this cumulative distribution function. So we have already calculated cumulative distribution function, which is in this question is f of x, which is this one. If x is less than equal to minus 1, it will be 0. If x lies between minus 1 and 2, it will be this. If x is greater than equal to 2, it will be 1. So, at this way, you will calculate cumulative distribution function. There is another example. The probability distribution function of the age of babies x year being brought to a postnatal clinic is given by. So, this is now your function. The same thing which define the same equation which define from 0 to 2. Otherwise, it will be equal to 0. So, minus infinity to 0, it will be 0. From 2 to plus infinity, it will be 0. If 60 babies are brought in on a particular day, how many are expected to be under 8 month old? So, now 8 month old. 8 month old, if you convert this, because there are 8 month in a year. So, 8 month old mean 12, 4 to the 8 and 4 to the, so 2 by 3 year. So, now we need to calculate that how many babies expected that are brought in, but how many are expected to be under 8 month old. So, x will be less than 8 months. So, 8 months you can write it 2 by 3 of a year. So, we will take start from 0 because if a child born, so mean he will start from 0. This is the age which you will start 0. From 0 you will start counting. 1 day, 2 day old, 3 day old, 4 day old, 5 month old, 6 month old, 7. So now we want to calculate those babies are brought in a particular day, how many are expected to be under 8 month old. So now we want to calculate this. And this is the function. So from 0 to 2 by 3. So 0 to 2 by 3, 2 by 3 will be lie at this place. And now we want to calculate this area. So, how we will calculate? You can easily calculate while simple. This will be going out. X into 2x. So, when it's getting out, 3 over 4. Okay. X will be multiply with this 2x minus x into x, x square. So, this will be dx. In the next step, you need to take the integration. When you take the integration, 3 by 4. Okay. 3 by 4. Now, 2x square. Over 2, this is 2 by 3, 0, minus x cube by 3, 2 by 3 and 0. So, this will be cancelled with this, 3 by 4, this is x square, minus x cube by 3 and the upper bound is 2 by 3 and the lower bound is 0. So, further simplifying it, 3 by 4, now x square, so you need to put 2 square over 3 square, minus 0 this is for the first function, minus 1 over 3, 2 over 3, 2 over 3, power 3, minus 0. Okay, so when you simplify it, you will get this. So this will be the probability, the expected chance that how many are expected to be, how many are expected to be under 8 month old. So this is the answer, that 25% will be under 8 month old. Okay, so I hope that you understand this. If you understand the basic concept of integration, you can easily calculate the area, you can easily calculate the probability of a specific event. In the expected number of babies, because now we are asking for the expectation. So the expectation formula is, because if you calculate this, now we have how many babies they brought into the postnatal clinic? 60 babies. So 60 divide, multiply by the answer, which we already 0.25 into 9. So when you multiply this, it will be equal to 15.56. So 15 to 16 babies are expected that they are under 8 month old. So the function which was obtained after integration and is used to calculate probabilities is called the cumulative distribution function. In last example, 3 over 4 x square minus x cube by 3. So we have already calculated this. This is your cumulative distribution function. Now if I ask you that how many are expected to be under 10 month old? So 10 month old, 10. So we can write this 10 by 12. So you not need to calculate 3 by 4 x square minus x cube by 3 and 10 by 12 from 0. So you just put this, automatically you will calculate the values. It is cumulative, as putting a single value in the function will give you the probability from 0 to a. So in this interval, all the values are acceptable. No violation will be occur. If you put the values between this interval, if you put 2, so you can easily calculate from 1 to 2, you can easily calculate. It is a cumulative, as putting a single value a in the function will give you the probability this. For example, probability baby is less than 6 month old. So baby is less than 6 month old. So how you will calculate 6 month old? 6, how you will calculate 6 month old? Is less than 6 month old. So 6 month, okay, when you calculate, so 6 by 12 is equal to 0.5. So you just put the value of x in which, in this equation, which is cumulative distribution function. So 0.5 square minus 0.5 cube by 3. Why are we not putting? Because if you put 0 from 0.5, because when a baby born, it will start from 0 and less than 6 month old, so 0.5. So 0.5, if you put 0, so that is why we not putting, we will only put the 0.5 value. So this, the probability of this is 15%. Once the cumulative function is known, it is unnecessary to repeat the integration for a new example. So cumulative distribution function prevents you from the complex integration. You not need to integrate it again and again if you just calculate this thing. In general, for a continuous probability f of x, cumulative distribution function is given by, so I already mentioned to you that it will be minus infinity to x f of x d of x. This is the general formulation. So I hope you understand.